Shane Warne's death hit Sam Newman harder than most. Few people knew the king of spin quite like Sam. I sat down with him today as he paid tribute to a Melbourne legend, the likes of which we'll never see again.
Like so many of us, Sam Newman is struggling to process the shock of Shane Warne's death.
I've lost a dear friend. He was just such a true, genuine person.
It's hard to talk about him in the past tense, isn't it?
As I say, it's surreal. On the day I learnt of his death, I was in bed and I heard the beep go on my phone, which was beside the bed, and I looked at it and it said, Shane Warne found dead. I honestly actually thought I was dreaming.
Sam spoke with him the day he flew out to Thailand. They planned to look at purchasing a car Shane had his eye on when he got back.
It is amazing to think that we won't speak again. It's just beyond belief.
Sam says he'll never forget Shane's support after wife Amanda's sudden death last year.
He really cared about how I was going. Yeah, so he did.
Melbourne's odd couple, Sam and Shane, were dear friends and golfing buddies for the best part of three decades.
We would argue for 10 minutes about the handicaps we'd play off, because I'm not long out of being put into a facility. Shane has just come back from parring St Andrews in a pro-am event.
So he was good?
Good. Had a hole, only man to have a hole-in-one at the par 3 16th in Augusta, where the pin placement was on the top right-hand corner. The only person ever to have had a hole-in-one there. If they'd had the sport of cricket in America, he'd be as big as anyone on the planet. He was just the most competitive and driven man I've ever met, and that's why he turned out to be the star he is. Was. Isn't it hard to say that?
How will you remember Shane Warne?
The very people who no one imagines anything of do things that no one can imagine. And that was him.